Hello, Cloud Gurus, and welcome to GCP Service Spotlight, where we put the spotlight on specific Google Cloud services. I'm Matthew Ulasien, and today we're going to talk about Cloud Run. In this episode, I'll cover why we care about Cloud Run, the common use cases and costs, then I'll go through a technical demonstration of Cloud Run in action, and then conclude by covering its pros and cons and whether or not you should invest your time into it. So, what exactly is Cloud Run? Simply put, Cloud Run is a fully managed serverless service that allows you to easily deploy stateless containerized applications without having to manage cluster infrastructure, which of course reduces costs. So that sounds great, but why do we actually care about that? Well, to understand that, let's first talk about the challenges of deploying containerized applications. Now, as you may know, modern cloud-native application development has shifted greatly toward using containers, typically Docker containers. This is because containers have a number of advantages over VMs, such as being much more lightweight and portable. However, deploying and scaling containerized applications can in itself be a bit of a challenge. Fortunately, powerful container orchestration platforms like Kubernetes make this process a lot easier by enabling advanced configurations, scalability, and much more importantly, greater control over complex containerized applications. However, Kubernetes clusters, even managed ones like Google Kubernetes Engine, require creating and paying for persistent clusters and nodes. This leads to ongoing costs and additional management overhead, which can simply be overkill when all you want to do is to deploy a simple container with a minimum of fuss. For scenarios like these, Cloud Run resolves this issue by letting us easily deploy simple containerized applications with a minimum of work and cost. With Cloud Run, there are no clusters or nodes to provision and manage. Just deploy container and that's it. It gives us the benefits of both containers and serverless all in one package. Oh, and it also means no need to continuously deal with YAML files, so that's a plus. Under the hood, Cloud Run is actually powered by a technology called Knative. Knative is an open source framework developed by Google to deploy these serverless containerized workloads. This means that under the hood, it's technically running on Kubernetes, except we don't have to care about or worry about all the different Kubernetes management bits. All we do is interact with deploying our containers, and that's all there is to it. Oh, and also since we are working with standard Docker containers, this also means that Cloud Run supports all programming languages, a lot of flexibility built into it. So then, what kind of benefits does Cloud Run give us? A lot, actually. As we already mentioned, it's fully managed and serverless, which lets us deploy a container without dealing with the infrastructure. Awesome. Scaling is also automatically handled for us, even scaling down to zero, and that's a really big deal. Like many serverless offerings, you only pay for what you use. This means that if your container is not in use, then it's not being charged. It's free. Also, since we don't deal with the underlying infrastructure, management and version control is also super easy. And there are many other benefits as well, such as HTTPS automatically enabled, the ability to map custom domains, and redundant deployments across multiple zones. So, does this mean that we can run all of our containers on Cloud Run? Well, not exactly. Cloud Run is designed specifically for stateless HTTP workloads. By stateless, I'm talking about that the container is not saving uploaded information to the container itself, although you can save data to connected storage services like managed databases and cloud storage, for example, and it's also really good practice. Common use cases include websites, API backends, and scheduled automation workflows. And the best part is, again, that when these types of applications are not in use, they again automatically scale down to zero, and again, you are not charged. However, with that in mind, Cloud Run would not be a good fit if you need stateful containers or if you need greater control or support for more complex configurations and workloads, in which case you'd want to use something like Kubernetes Engine. Wrapping up our overview, let's discuss how we pay for Cloud Run. Cloud Run is a pay-for-use service, which means that we pay for every second our container is running, and we don't pay when it's not. Pricing is based on the amount of CPU and memory consumed per second, as well as a flat rate per million requests. And it also comes with a generous free tier for occasionally running workloads. So with that, let's head out to the demo and let's see Cloud Run in action. Okay, let's jump into our hands-on demonstration of working with Cloud Run. For this demo, we are going to create two separate deployments and show how we can split traffic between different versions. Now, the basic process of working with Cloud Run is as follows. We need to first start by creating our own Docker container for some source code currently located in our Cloud Shell. Once we create our Docker container, we will then go ahead and push it to the container registry service. And then from container registry, we will then deploy that onto the Cloud Run service itself, once again, without having to worry about the infrastructure that powers that service. Let's go ahead and jump over to Cloud Shell and take a look at the source code that we are going to use. In Cloud Shell, we have three separate files we are going to use for our custom container. We have an app.py file, which is going to be a containerized Python Flask application, which will be used for our web-based application. We have a Docker file, which is necessary to create our Docker container. And we have a webpage.html file, which is going to display our website text, which is going to say, hello, GCP service spotlight in blue, and then followed by welcome to Cloud Run. Let's go ahead and start the first part of our process by creating our Docker container. Now, before I do anything else, I'm going to start by exporting my current project ID of ACG Cloud Run Demo as a shell variable, which will be designated by the project underscore ID variable that you see here. This is going to be useful for the upcoming commands. Next, we need to take our source code and create a Docker container, which will be used via the Docker build command, in which we are going to tag it with our container registry name, which is going to be Docker build -t for tag. And our container registry name will be gcr.io, our project ID designated by the project ID variable, and then followed by our container image name, which is going to be Cloud Run Demo. And then followed by a period to designate that we are using the current directory. And then our image is now building. This will take about 10 seconds or so. We will speed the video up until it is done. Okay, now that we have our new image, our next step is to push it to the container registry service, which will be done via the Docker push command, once again providing the path to our container registry image, which will be again gcr.io, project ID, and Cloud Run Demo. Let's clear our screen. Type in Docker push, gcr.io, project ID with our shell variable, and then once again, Cloud Run Demo. And this process should complete in just a few seconds. Very good. At this point, we have created our Docker container and pushed it to the container registry service. Let's go ahead and double check that by looking at the container registry service itself. In our search, we'll type in container, click on container registry. We have Cloud Run Demo here, and we have a single version of our application. Excellent. Let's now go ahead and jump over to Cloud Run and get to the part that we care about, in which we are going to deploy this new container image. To get there, we'll go to our top left menu, go down to compute, and then click on Cloud Run. Once we're in the Cloud Run service, we'll go ahead and start by creating a new service. In our service settings, we need to choose a location. I'm going to go ahead and choose US Central 1 because that's where I'm at. Also notice we have the option if we have an Anthos subscription of also deploying Cloud Run on a Kubernetes engine cluster. However, this does require an Anthos subscription in order to do so. In our case, we will use the fully managed option. Let's go ahead and give our service name a name of Cloud Run Demo. And then click on Next. Next, we need to choose what first version of our container image that we are going to deploy. To do so from our container image URL screen, we'll go ahead and click on Select, expand our Cloud Run Demo container registry location, and then choose our container image that we pushed just a moment ago. Also notice that we have the option of automating this process by using the Cloud Build service to automatically deploy new versions of our container images in scenarios in which we will be frequently updating our code, shown by the continually deploy newer versions from a source repository option here. Also notice before we move on, if we expand advanced settings, we have a number of other parameters we can adjust. We are going to leave the defaults, but if we take a quick look here, we can choose our container port. We can choose how much memory and CPUs to dedicate to each individual container instance. We can dedicate anywhere from 128 up to 4 gigabytes of memory or even more. And we can use 1, 2, or 4 CPUs for each individual image as well. And also notice if we scroll down, we can set our auto scaling settings in which by default, we can scale down to 0 in which we are not being charged if our image is not being used. and we can set a maximum number to scale up to. In this case, our default is 1,000 individual copies of our container. Again, this auto-scaling is 100% managed for us. If we then click on Next, our final step is to configure how our service is triggered. Since we are working with a publicly available HTTP website, we are going to choose to allow unauthenticated invocations. Notice we have more secure options, and we also have the option to add additional triggers, such as in response to other events, such as Google Cloud events or other events as well. Notice there is some overlap here with cloud functions in which we can wait for an event from another service or action in order to execute. The main difference, though, is that with Cloud Run, we are using container images, which can use any application library, as opposed to cloud functions, which is limited to a few individual languages. In our demo, we are not going to use a custom trigger. We'll go ahead and click on Cancel, leave it as HTTP, and then click on Create, which will then kick off our first deployment. And then just like that, we have a newly created container images deployed out into production. Now, the main takeaway at this point is that we did not have to worry about spinning up any infrastructure, such as a Kubernetes cluster, to deploy this container to. Behind the scenes, this is running on Kubernetes. However, Cloud Run manages all the Kubernetes management bits, such as working with nodes, clusters, YAML files, and kubectl commands on your behalf, so you don't have to. Let's go ahead and verify our website is up and running by clicking on our URL. Then after a brief moment, we have our Hello GCP Server Spotlight. Welcome to Cloud Run. Very good. We now have a new container up and running. Taking a quick look around at some of our options, notice that we automatically are collecting performance metrics and logs based on everything going on in our container, such as request count, request latency, memory utilization of our container. We have detailed logs powered by the cloud logging service. Again, everything related to our container we have logs for. And also interesting to note, if we click on the YAML heading here, we can see the Kubernetes YAML file that was automatically created and managed on our behalf. In this case, this was a Kubernetes service that was used to publicly expose our containerized website to the general public. So very good. You saw how easy it was to deploy a container into production without having to manage any background infrastructure using the Cloud Run service. Let's go ahead and wrap up this demo by doing the same thing again to deploy a version 2 of our application with a slight twist that we are going to use the command line for our next Cloud Run deployment. Let's go ahead and jump back over to Cloud Shell to see what this is going to look like. Now it's going to be largely the same steps before. We need to create our Docker container or build it, push to container registry, and then we are going to use command line to create our new Cloud Run deployment from container registry. Let's go ahead and set this up by going back into our Cloud Shell editor. Back in our HTML file, we're just going to replace our welcome to Cloud Run text with version 2, just so we know this is version 2 of our application. Save it, and then close out of that. So let's go ahead and build our new container. I'm just going to arrow up a couple times to our Docker build command. That's going to build a new version of that container, and that will complete in just a moment. Looks like it was pretty quick. Let's now go ahead and re-push it out to container registry again. And now we have two images sitting in our container registry. Clear our screen, and now let's briefly cover the command we are going to use for our second Cloud Run deployment. So on your screen, the command we are going to use is going to be gcloud run deploy in the name of our service, which is Cloud Run Demo. We need to point to the latest version of our version 2 application. Once again, allow unauthenticated access, use the fully managed platform, and then use the US Central 1 region and our current project ID shown by the project ID variable. For demonstration's sake, I'm going to go ahead and copy and paste that command from off screen, which is the same thing we just looked at. Hit enter, and in about 5 to 10 seconds, we will have the newest version of our application deployed. Let's go ahead and go back over to Cloud Run to verify. Refresh our page. And we now have a version 2 up and running, which automatically directed 100% of our traffic to. We can go ahead and verify by clicking on our URL. And we have version 2 of our GCP Server Spotlight page here. Outstanding. So the very last thing we're going to do is show how just as easily we can deploy new container images, we can also easily manage traffic going from one version to another. Let's say we have a scenario in which we need to revert our traffic back to a previous version of our application, or we want to split traffic between one version and another. Once again, this process is quite simple. If we click on our Manage Traffic button here, At the moment, we are sending 100% of our traffic to the latest version. However, we can split it up 50-50, as long as everything equals 100. Or we also have the option of sending 100% of our traffic to the previous version 1 by sending 100% of traffic to here, and we can even delete an older or newer version if we need to as well. In this example, I'm going to revert our traffic back over to version 1 of our application, in which case we have 100% going to 01, and then click on Save. That will once again take about 10 seconds. I'm going to go ahead and close out of our older tab here. And then once that is up, I'm going to go ahead and click on our URL again. And if we did everything correctly, we should now have our previous version, which says Welcome to Cloud Run as opposed to version 2. So very good. At this point, we demonstrated how easy it is to deploy a 100% ready-to-go container out to the public world without having to worry about the underlying Kubernetes infrastructure that is required to power those containers. As you can see, the process of deploying new containers and also the process of creating multiple versions and even splitting traffic among those versions is a very simple process. Excellent. Let's go ahead and finish things up by giving my final thoughts. So now that you've seen it in action, let's summarize the pros and cons of Cloud Run. Like we saw in the demo, it is a fantastic tool to get a relatively simple stateless application up and working quickly without having to deal with the underlying infrastructure. We also saw how easy it was to deploy and configure our application, and version control was easy peasy. With that in mind, Cloud Run is not the right choice for every containerized workload. For example, if our application is much more complex and requires greater orchestration, or we need to save state, or if we need more control over where the container runs and who has access from a network control perspective, we would instead want to use a full-featured orchestration platform like Kubernetes, including Kubernetes Engine. So, should you invest, evaluate, or revisit? My recommendation is to invest in Cloud Run for scenarios that fit the use case it was designed for, which are again, simple stateless HTTP containers. It's not the best solution for every containerized workload, but for scenarios like websites or scheduled automation workflows, it is the easiest and most cost-effective way to get those applications up and running. Use the right tool for the job, and this tool has a very strong place. Oh, and by the way, if you want to learn even more about Cloud Run in more depth, be sure to check out our Cloud Run Deep Dive course created by Tim Berry, where you can learn even more about its features, including how to automate your container deployment using Cloud Build. It's really good stuff. Well, that's it for this episode, folks. Keep being awesome cloud gurus, and I hope to see you in the next episode of GCP Service Spotlight. Farewell.